As you may have heard, as part of the broad Yield Transform project, we are also set up one in Accra, at Accra Digital Center, where we're going to have a mobile lab and another innovative hub. What we are starting with PMESD to do in the northern part of Ghana, and to be hosted at the Kumasi Business Incubator. We want to assure Ghanaians, and let me take this on to that, the government of His Excellency is committed to what we call the new Ghanaian civilization. And as part of that, and as we have demonstrated, there are numerous electronic products that we have rolled out, there are numerous digital products, the EIE, paperless clearing systems. Recently, a couple of weeks ago, if you are not aware, we inaugurated the case tracking system of the judicial service, where we are putting a system where you'll be able to track your case online, so that the issue of files being lost and everything will be a thing of the past. We also recently come with the mobile money interoperability, where you'll be able to send money across networks, where you don't be dedicated to other networks. We are also continuing with the e-services, e-passports, e-procurement, the e-immigration, all as part of making sure that we digitize this economy. I'm sure recently that I've heard the issues about our effort to also be able to monitor revenues in the mobile industry in real time, which has never been done. And this is all part of the ways to ensure that we are not left behind. We are key stakeholders and players in the digital ecosystem, and to ensure that Ghana and our youth also have a chance to be part of this 21st century phenomenon as well. I wish to thank you very much for coming. Let me also thank once again KNUST for offering their center as a continuation of the partnership we have with them under the eGhana project. And we are very sure, we are hopeful that a lot of our young guys up the north will be able to assess your center, will bring their ideas there, will provide the environment for them to make sure that we have a lot of startups and some business and then play a role in this digital ecosystem, not just in the region, but worldwide. Because when you engage with other players in the global ecosystem, everyone is talking about innovation, everyone is talking about ideas based on digital economy, based on technology that can provide solutions. And that's where the real money is. That is where our contribution and the role that we play in the global ecosystem will be felt. Ideas about business, ideas about technology is everywhere. And I believe that we have to give the children of this country also the chance and opportunity and to create a livable environment for them to do that. That's why we are here today to do that for KNUST for another part of Ghana once again. And we will very soon be launching the one at Accra Digital Center to cater for those in the Southern Center. So thank you for coming, and I hope that you'll be able to let people understand that the Minister of Communication, and for that matter, His Excellency the President, is committed as part of the broader Ghana Beyond Aid agenda to use technology to develop this country. Thank you very much.
As a science and technology university, you all agree with me that we couldn't have been left out for the ministry to have thought of us as good partners for this project. It's a big testimony of our capability. We've had a e-Ghana transform which is about $495,000 about 4 years ago, and everybody can attest the fact that we perform credibly, and I should think it explains why we have a second tranche. If we have to transform Ghana technologically, KNUST is the main driver. And as a country, we have been using a lot of technologies that are foreign. If you look at WhatsApp, Instagram, they are all foreign. They don't often address the challenges that we have as a country. And therefore, this project is to be able to indigenize or find indigenous ways of solving our country challenges and bringing young, intelligent, smart, as university graduates together to think through the challenges that we have as a country. So we're challenging all of them in a room to come up with innovative ways by which we can move this country and our agenda forward. And I can promise that KMUSC in the next year will be able to change this country technologically through our young men and women, and we promise to be training between 200, 500 young men who, again, ripple effects from their training will eventually bring on board about 10,000 plus young men and women technologically trained and, again, with a lot of innovation in them to be able to move our country forward. I look forward to more pieces from the ministry to at least see what we're doing, and I will not be left alone half more. And we'll have short pieces from the ministry to be able to together change this country for the good.